Hi viewers, this is Meenakshindra Mansito. Welcome to my channel. You are watching Ganesh Tutoriums. Are you all ready to learn? Let me start the class. In this video, I am going to introduce a new topic, quadratic formula. It is nothing but we can use this quadratic formula to find the roots of a given quadratic equation. Clear? Actually, we can use this formula to find when they given a quadratic equation, we can easily find the roots of a given equation. For example, we all know that the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c, we know that it is a general form of quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, right? Are you all know this? Be a quadratic equation, then the roots of a quadratic equation is, then the root of a quadratic equation, we can say that x is equal to minus b, minus is nothing but the coefficient of x, minus b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. Are you all clear? Actually, minus b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4a value coefficient of x squared, b value, c value constant one. Clear? Any doubt? And also, we know that a quadratic equation has a two roots, right? Okay, that is a one formula. It is can be stated here. It is they given as a plus or minus, right? So plus one root, minus one root. Here, see here, minus b plus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, and one more root x is equal to, here is a plus or minus, so minus b minus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. Are you all clear? Any doubt? So it is a quadratic formula. We can use this quadratic formula to find the roots of a given quadratic equation. Clear? In this earlier classes, we used the middle term splitting method to find the factor. We can find the factors, middle term splitting method, and we used the completing square method also. Here now we can use a quadratic formula. Clear? This quadratic formula derived from complete square method. Right? Clear? Any doubt? Now I will explain how the formula derived from the complete square method. Clear? So we all know that ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. It is in a quadratic equation, right? So in a complete square method, what we supposed to do first? We can make this coefficient of x squared is a 1. So we can divide by a and the entire equation. So ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Each term divided by a. Right? We all know this, right? Clear? Then what we supposed to do? We can cancel this. So remaining we can get x squared plus bx by a plus c by a. 0 by a, it is 0. Right? Clear? Any doubt? So next step, we can make it as a form of identity a squared. What is the x term and x squared term in between? There is a plus. So a squared plus 2ab plus b squared is equal to a plus b the whole squared. Clear? Any doubt? So now I want the 2 here. So the same thing, the x squared plus I want a 2 here. So what I supposed to do? I just do the multiplication and divide it to in the second term alone, x term alone, by a plus c by a equal to 0. Clear? Any doubt? So next step, x squared plus 2 into a value, that is x, into remaining b by 2a. Clear? So 2 times of a x into b by a, b by the remaining term, plus c by a equal to 0. Now it is in a form of x squared plus 2 into a into b, right? So now we can use x squared plus 2 into x into b by 2a. Now what is the value of b? Here it is a value, here 2, a, b. So b value is b by 2a, right? So now we need a b squared. So we can add a b square, b by 2a the whole square, and we should subtract a b by 2a the whole square. Then constant of c by a, which is equal to 0. Are you all clear? Any doubt? So next we know that this one as a x minus
b value a minus b value a value x b value b by 2a the whole square which is equal to sorry minus b by 2a the whole square plus c by a equal to 0 clear any doubt so next x minus b by 2a the whole square which is equal to clear now we can sorry minus now we can give the square here so b square minus 4a square plus c by a equal to 0 clear any doubt so next step so now we can do the subtraction here different sign so we can do the subtraction and we can find the lcm of 4a square and a so 4a square and a lcm of 4a square and a that is 4a square clear so x minus b by 2a the whole square next plus bracket minus b squared by whole divided by 4a square plus now I want to make this a as a 4a square so I can multiply with some number to become 4a square what are they 4 into a when I multiply 4 into a to a only I can get a 4a square so same thing we should multiply 4a on the numerator so 4ac equal to 0 clear any doubt next step x minus b by 2a the whole square which is equal to here it is a whole term symbol is plus it will go that side become a minus so minus of the whole term minus b square plus 4ac divided by 4a square clear so next x minus b by 2a is equal to squared equal to now you can multiply the minus inside so minus into minus plus so plus b square minus 4ac divided by 4a square so next step x minus b by 2a is equal to here it is a square so it will go this become a root of the value so b square minus 4ac divided by 4a square so next step x minus b by 2a is equal to root of b squared minus 4ac divided by root of 4a square clear any doubt clear so next step x minus b by 2a equal to so root of b squared minus 4ac clear we can't take this as a come out of root here b squared but it is here in a subtraction so we couldn't take a b here now it is a square 4a square so that 4a square you can write root of 4a square you can write this as a root of 2 into 2 4 as a 2 into 2 a is a into a right so 1 2 here 1 a so we get 2a so that is it comes out it's a 2a clear so root of 4a square you can get it as a 2a clear according to this right so next one x is equal to now here is a minus so it will go that it become a plus so root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a here is a minus so here plus b by 2a are you all clear sorry here it is a minus right so it is plus it is in a identity form that is x plus only no so the identity is plus here right clear any doubt the identity is plus not a minus clear sorry the small changes it is a minus plus identity clear any doubt so now it the minus will come the plus will comes under this side it became a minus clear so you can write x is equal to minus b by 2a minus b by 2a here plus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a then x is equal to minus b plus root of b squared minus 4ac clear so it here it is a root right so square root will go side become when you are taking out a common root it is a plus or minus so here also plus or minus because it is root so plus or minus so here also plus or minus then here also plus or minus so plus or minus the whole divided by 2a is the LCM. Clear? Clear? Any doubt? So now x is equal to minus b plus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, and one more, minus b minus root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. Clear? Now we derived the answer, x value. There is a root. These are the two roots. Clear? Clear? And one more thing that is more important. If b squared minus 4ac greater than or equal to 0, this term, greater than or equal to 0, actually more than 0 or 0, more than 0 or 0, then we get this as a real root. That's the more important, real root. Suppose b squared minus 4ac less than 0, that is a smaller one, less than, smaller one, that is a negative number, we can get a, it's not real root, it's the imaginary root. Clear? So here you can mention it is a not real root. That is a more important, this two. Clear? Clear? So when we solve b squared minus 4ac, it is a positive number or 0, it is a real root. When it is in a negative number, we can call it as a not real root. That is the imaginary root. Clear? Any doubt?
I hope in this video you make clear about the problem. Thank you for watching my video. If it is any doubt, you can ask me in a comment. Thank you.